dealing with wicked powers of the night. Can we say that together? There are wicked powers of the night. Very quickly, let's go to the book of Psalm 91, verse 5. The Bible said, thou shalt not be afraid. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night. Number one, there is a terror. There are terrors that fly in the night. Terrors by night. Ugly, hellish, dangerous activities that take place in the night. All cultic activities are in the night. And many of them, hellish. All the rituals at night. When do people see moving ghosts? At night. Am I communicating? Witches and wizard activities at night. Astral projections. Astral traveling at night. Occultic activities at night. Many demonic and wicked sacrifices, they are done in the night. In the book of Matthew, chapter 13, verse 24 and 25, the Bible said, another parable put it forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. But when men slept, the kingdom of God is like what? A man which sowed what? Good seed in his field. The good man there could be, the man there could be God. He sowed good seed inside all of you looking at me. Wonderful destiny. Wonderful star. Wonderful star. Beautiful, gift. Oh, very attractive destiny. God gave to all of you looking at me. There is no man God didn't put something inside to display to his world. Whether he's supposed to be a carpenter, a special carpenter. But you see, if that star in you is not shining, then something is wrong. You need to fight for it. You need to fight for it. It's abnormal. And that's what I'm trying to make you understand. The kingdom of God is like a parable. It's like what? A man who sowed a good seed in his field. But while men slept, the enemy came. What time? At the night. When men are sleeping, he came at the night. And do what? And so tars. Brother, hear me. The devil plants wickedness in the life of people at night. Many times in their dreams. At night, when they are not observant. At night, when they are not conscious, the enemy comes and plants seed. As we live here today, whatever the Lord has not planted in our lives, they have to be uprooted. They have to be uprooted. Brother, hear me. The night is a period where wicked men destroy the destinies of people. A lot of people, their destinies are damaged in the night. I share with them here some strange experiences. Which one do I say? One is a doctor, not far from here in this city. Strange stories. This one will say his own. This one will say, the other one said she had a miscarriage in the same hospital. And when she was lying down, two or three of them men surrounded her bed. And he was looking at the doctor himself. And he said to them, shoot her, shoot her. And she replied and said, not possible. After you have taken the blood. Now what does that show you? This man is a human animal. Supposed to take care of life, but he's destroying lives. And by the time I was hearing this story, I remember the case I know also from here. The sister told me, when they, over strange circumstance, and he said they have to induce, they have to force miscarriage. They said that the child is no more there. They have to flush it out. And at the end of the day, questionable flush, what came out? Twins. And since that time, that woman has never been able to take in again. Whenever she takes, she keep on having miscarriages. The same doctor. These are days when you are going some places, you have to ask God, please, who is this man? A sister was sick here and was carried to a hospital here. And by the time we realized what was happening, the sister who walked into this place had become a corpse.
told him, leave her there. We pastors, all of us rushed there, went there. Big complex. But there is no human being in the hospital. And I said, what made you people, to bring this sister here? In a hospital that there is no human being. What closed this place down in the first place? Do you think that people who stop coming here, they themselves don't have brain? We stood there, surrounded, and declared this sister is not for sacrifice. We kept praying and praying. It was a fight. And she came back to life. And by the time she came back, and I asked her, well, how did you come here? She walked in there. Nobody carried her. The Bible said, to be carnally minded is death. The Bible said, be led by the Spirit of God. Am I communicating to somebody in this meeting? Brethren, we need to begin to understand that the night is when wicked men plant sicknesses into the lives of people. Evil men, they plant evil in the life of people. So many people, their organs are exchanged. Some people, their stars are exchanged. I told you a story here. The girl said, the boy said, in the family, all the men in the family, he said he removed their brains and put good different animal head brains inside their head. Why? He said when they were young, whoever comes had the best result in the family is given a piece of meat. And what others did not know was that this young man was already in witchcraft. So he removed their brains so that he will always be the person having the best result for a piece of meat. So the family had a conglomeration, a package of human-headed animals. Human beings with animal heads. Why? Because of one wicked child in their midst. When was this thing done? At night. Brethren, that's why we need to fight. Because why? The night is a conference hour of the rulers of the darkness of this world. That's when they meet. That's when they decide over the destinies of people. The Bible says, why did you hear the rage and the people imagine different things? The kings of the earth, they set themselves together. That's when they have their conference. And they sit together. And then they begin to pray. A girl came. She was here. And she was telling me. She was lying on the bed. And suddenly, somebody who's supposed to be a spiritual leader, and a lady, came with three nurses. And they surrounded, all of them dressed in nursing attire. They surrounded her on the bed. And then they were carrying forceps, those three that nurses and doctors carry in the operation room. And she pointed at her and said, cut off the womb at night. So many people don't know what happened to them. That's why I want to tell you have to pray. Some of you don't even know why you are here. You are here because you need to do some battle. You are not here by accident. I always tell people that I am a priest, no doubt. But can I tell you, I cannot leave the ministry of prayer. Why? Because I know where I'm coming from. If you don't know where you are coming from, you are a fool. A fool at the boiling point. Wasn't it who said? Bishop Abraham Chibundo. He said, if you don't know where you are coming from, he said, believe you me, you don't know where you are. And where you are going is not clearly defined. It's not clearly defined. You need to know where you are coming from. You need to know your background. And if you are coming from the kind of background I come from, you must pray. What did I say? You must pray. Job 33, verse 20. The Bible says, because wicked men, they wreak havoc in the life of men in the night. 36, verse 20. Wicked men wreak havoc in the people's life at night. Discern not the night when people are cut off in their place. God is talking to you. He said, don't desire the night. Don't desire to be a sleepy man or woman. Don't desire the night. Don't be a lousy man. He said, don't desire it when people are cut off in the night. My brother, the night is a time when people are cut off in their sleep. It is a time when wicked men have conferences over the life of people. It is a period of satanic transaction. It is a period of what? Satanic transaction. And God is calling me and you not to fall in love with sleep. You must be, if you want to amount to anything in life, you must watch over the night. There are gates of time. The time of the evening sacrifice is a time gate. 12 o'clock is a time gate. 6 o'clock is a time gate. There are gates of time. And God is saying to you, this time gate, don't desire it. It is foolishness to be sleeping at a time when wicked powers are sitting in a conference and discussing, what do we do with this guy now? Do we collect him immediately? Or do we just start torturing his life quietly until we take him off when he's tired? Let's kill him slowly. That's what they were praying for somebody there, and then somebody began to manifest from inside the person. I was talking and said that they don't want to kill him immediately, that they want to kill him and torture him and kill him slowly. And that was a human being. Identified himself, and the person they are talking from inside knows the person. And that will tell you how far they have gone inside him. Do not desire the night. In the book of Job, again, 34, verse 20, the Bible said, very powerful, in a moment they shall die. And the people shall be troubled at midnight and pass away, and the mighty shall be taken away when without hand. Brethren, listen. The midnight is a spiritual gate. A spiritual gate of very powerful importance. Later on, you will discover that when our God wants to kill, he goes to kill at midnight. Did you hear what I said now? Our God goes to do what? Kill when? Bible says the midnight is a time people die. It is a time people pass away. It is a time people do what? Are troubled. How many people in the night, they tell you? Nightmares. They can't sleep. Horrible dreams. Is somebody hearing me? One said his eyes was opened and he was seeing headless human beings. And they were talking, but all the human beings moving in a tray, in a line, not one of them have a head. Imagine when you see such a sight. When you wake up, you can't stay in the room. When they want to switch off the light, you say, please leave it on. These are days when we pray. The kind of wickedness we have in the land now, all over the world, Satanism is on the rampage. If you don't know, I'm informing you. The night is a period of powerful demonic activities. A lot of sacrifices, rituals take place in the night. There are some people in the night, they go naked, moving around in the night to conjure powers. In the night, I was staying somewhere some years ago, and one of those nights, we saw an old woman, half naked, carried a pot on her head, and this pot was steaming fire, and she was walking around the village in the night. She was taking authority. Cauldron manipulations. A lot of people's destinies and lives, they are decided and manipulated at night. Why? The night is vulnerable. At night, man is vulnerable. In the sleepy state, the spirit of a man is weak. What did I say? At the sleepy state, the spirit of a man, no matter how big, no matter how tall, is weak. And wicked men, they know. And that's why, that's when they invoke them. That's when they carry you to one conference. They move you to another one. You get confused. They bring you to the banquet. Before you know it, they give you gari, give you akamu, give you koto, 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 koto. Useless poison you eat. Acts chapter 16, verse 25. The Bible says, at midnight, Paul and Silas, they prayed and sang songs. I want you to know that if you go to the book of Psalms, 119, verse 62, the Bible tells us that God enjoys thanksgiving. If you God does anything good for you, please don't forget to thank him. Amen. Paul and Silas, they realize that there is a time. and the time is midnight. God kills at night. God fights at night. He fought for Paul and Barnabas at night. He will fight for you. I didn't hear a good amen. God goes to kill the wicked at night. Exodus chapter 11, verse 4 to 6. The Bible says, and Moses said, thus says the Lord, about the midnight. Somebody said, midnight. I will go out into the midst of Egypt. And all the firstborn in the land of Egypt shall die. From the firstborn of Pharaoh that sitteth upon the throne, even unto the firstborn of the meat servant that is behind the meal. And all the firstborn of the beasts. At midnight, God went and slaughtered them. And there shall be a great cry. And there was. The night is the best time. The best time to pray in the fear of God, terror of God, into the dream of your enemies. I told you here, sometime, somebody when they got a school in Avon, we were in the same hostel. And we came here, I met him, and all of us were teaching. And he was a year ahead of me. Somehow, they made him a principal, and I was his vice. Every day, this man wanted to conquer me. Every day, it's like he was looking for every opportunity to ridicule me in the school. You know, I don't know. I just kept overlooking it, feeling it's one of those things you expect from an unbeliever. So one day, the thing assumed a different dimension. So I went back to God. I said, Chineke, who is this man? And the Lord said to me, I have been waiting for you to ask this question. You are dealing with a practicing mystic. He went with him that night. I called him. He appeared. I destroyed him. I spoke destruction to his altar. I dealt with the altar. Dealt with the thing. He said, look, everybody's got a relationship. All the curses in Deuteronomy with a bottle of perfume. Hear me. The next day, everyone said the next day, when I came to school, hey, Chima, where you came? Reverend. He was the first person that called me Reverend. Reverend, where you came? I'm going to get the number. I agree. Show you that here I'm in an abali. Oh, Maria. From that day, he never harassed me again. It's time for you to harass your enemies. Did you hear what I said? You didn't hear what I said. Did you hear me? Listen to me. Do you know why many of you cannot harass them till now? Because from today you will harass them from now. Do you know why? You have not realized very well. You still have fear in your heart when you remember them and how people talk about them. Stop! Light must conquer darkness. Everyone say that again. Say it again. Say it again. Say, I am a child of the light. In the book of Esther 6, 1 to 10. Look at. On that night, could not the king sleep? Your kings will not sleep. And he commanded to bring the book of the records and the chronicles that they may come and read it before the king. And it was found that Mordecai, the guy who revealed that they wanted to kill Ahasuerus, nothing has been done for him. Yes. And the king said, what honor and dignity has been done for this guy? And they said, nothing. He said, there is nothing. He said, who is there? I saw Haman. He said, come here. The rest of the story, you can read it from there to verse 10. Look up, because I want to close. This thing happened, and Mordecai was forgotten. After 3 days prayer, 3 days, 3 nights, the king could not sleep. When you do your battle at midnight, your king will not sleep. The man that is supposed to marry will not sleep. The sister that is rejected to marry will not sleep. The one that is troubling your life will not sleep. Am I communicating? Hear me, brethren. I was sharing with them in here some of my own testimonies 40 days and 40 nights. They wanted to take my father's land from me. I declared 40 days and 40 nights. At the end of the 40 days and 40 nights, I headed home. Sorry, 40 days and 32 nights. I headed home, angry. Walked straight to the house of the man who was the chairman on how to take my land from me. And when I got there, I said to the wife, "Where is your husband?" I said, "No, no." I said, "Akedia." I said, "Oya." I said, "Nabakia." I said, "Achi mawa no here." That means, "Oya de kuokuya neba." And the man came. And when the man walked in, immediately he saw me, he knelt down. That's when all a man will put on a twigu. And I was looking at him. I said, "Chima, nayasi na yebunkemabun kemoburi anatema." I said, "Amen." God arrested the principality that was holding my thing. When you fast, when you pray, midnight prayers, God will arrest your principalities. All your stolen blessings shall be vomited, shall be vomited, shall be vomited, shall be vomited. Shall be vomited.